Hi students, in the previous topic we have seen the input-output processor. Now we are going to look at serial communication. A data communication processor is used to distribute and collect the data from many remote terminals connected through telephone and other communication lines. Data communication processor is also one kind of input-output processor. The striking difference between the data communication processor and input-output processor is the way they communicate with the remote terminals or other devices. Data communication processor uses single pair of wires, whereas input-output processor uses common bus, bunch of lines. Okay. Now, when a block of data is being transferred, many parity bits are generated for the purpose of error checking, and there are different ways to generate these parity bits. One way is to use LRC, longitudinal redundancy check. The other way is cyclic redundancy check. In the longitudinal redundancy check, parity bits are generated to indicate the length of the number of bits that are being transmitted in a line, whereas in the cyclic redundancy check, parity bits are generated according to a polynomial code that is transferred through feedback shift register. Okay, so information is transmitted along with these parity bits so that these parity bits can be used to find the errors present in the data received by the receiver. Now, data can be transmitted between two points in three different modes. One is simplex, that is one-way communication like radio. Only the transmitter sends the data, receiver can receive. The receiver can never send the data to transmitter. The second way is half duplex, that is two-way communication but one direction at a time, like a walkie-talkie. If transmitter is sending the data, receiver has to receive. If the receiver is transmitting the data, transmitter has to listen. Okay. Now, the third type of data transmission method is full duplex, where two-way communication and both can speak at a time, like mobile communication. Okay. Now, when two entities are communicating, they will set of rules, and they follow those rules so that they can do this communication efficiently, and this is called protocol. Set of rules followed by both the entities for the orderly transfer of information. Now, there are two types of, all the protocols are classified into two categories. One is character oriented protocol, the other one is bit oriented protocol. Okay, so this classification of protocols depends on the framing of the data while transmitting from source to the destination. So let us look at this character oriented protocol. Okay, so here this is the typical message format used in character oriented protocol. So the data can be classified into two parts, like generally we write a letter with a header and that is followed by text. So in this format, all the data is classified into two parts, header and text. And header and text is sent along with some communication control characters. Communication control characters like SYN, SOH, STX, ETX, each and every communication control character is having a specific purpose. For example, SYN. SYN is used to establish the synchronism between source and the destination. If you observe in the typical message format, two SYN communication control characters are used to start the message format. And before sending the header, SOH is used, whereas SOH means start of the heading. Okay. And before sending the text, STX is used. STX means start of text. At the end of the text, ETX is used, that represents end of the text. And at the end of the message format, block check character is used, block check character to check the presence of errors. Okay, this is a typical message format which is having communication control characters. Okay, now let us go to the second type of protocol, bit oriented protocol. Here, instead of characters, a stream of bits, serial bit stream of any length will be used as the information. Okay, you can check the format here. This is the format, and this information, any number of bits is the core. Now, this information is not sent alone. This will be sent along with address, control, frame check bits, and flags. These flags indicate the will be the boundaries of the frame. Okay, they indicate the start and they indicate the end. Okay, so address is very important. It is 8-bit address, so 256 different addresses are possible. Now, control bits, there are three different formats of controls are possible. We will look into them later. And frame check bits, again, they are used to identify the presence of errors, and that is possible to do. These frame check bits are generated using CRC in this protocol, cyclic redundancy check, a polynomial code that is passed through feedback shift register, which is having many exclusive OR gates. Okay, so let us look at this information. Here it is saying that information of any number of bits. Okay, so when they are saying any number of bits, there is a possibility of getting such combination 0 6 1 0, which is considered as flag. So in order to avoid occurrence of this flag in the information, we use a technique called zero insertion. Whenever the information is having a flag kind of data, then you know a zero will be added in the somewhere in this pattern, so that this flag occurrence can be avoided. Okay, now let us look at this control format. There are three different types of formats. 8-bit control information. Okay, these are the three modes. One is information transfer, the second one is supervisory, and the last one is unnumbered. In the information transfer, this control information can be used to transfer the data from source to destination or destination to source. Okay, so this is identified by the first bit 0. If you observe the three formats, the first bit is 0 only in information center. So whenever the first bit is in 0 in the control field format, that indicates the mode is information transfer. If it is 1, then that mode could be either supervisory or unnumbered, and that is identified by the next bit. Okay, if the next bit is 0, first bit is 1 and second bit is 0, then the mode is supervisory. If first and second bits are 1, that is unnumbered. So with the help of these bits, it is possible to identify the type of control field format it is. Okay, in the information transfer, NS stands for send count, NR stands for receiver count, whereas PF is used to indicate pole final. Okay, so this bit oriented protocol format can be transmitted by either source or destination. So if the source is sending the data, then P equal to 1. If the receiver is sending the data, F will become 1, pole or final. So P and F distinguish between the source and destination, who is sending the data to whom. Okay, in order to distinguish between the that information, this fifth bit is used, whereas 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8 are used to count the number of bits transmitted. Okay, now let us look at the supervisory. Supervisory mode is used to assist the data transfer and to accept the data transfer. Okay, so here one device will be sending the data, the other device will be receiving the data. That's why there is no NS. Send count is not there. Only NR is there, because this mode is used to use it for receiving the data only. Okay, and the last method is last format is unnumbered, which is used for initialization of link functions to convey procedural errors. Okay, that kind of thing. Okay, no information is transferred here. That's why there is no there are no NS or NR here, because while there is no information being transferred, no need to count. Okay, this is for special purpose, initialization of links or procedural to indicate procedural errors, that kind of. So these are the three formats of control field format of this frame format. Okay, so frame format is having information, and along with this information, address control, frame check bits, and this frame is having boundaries, flags. Flags are the boundaries of this frame. Okay, so this is the serial communication, and we have seen two different types of protocols: character oriented protocols, bit oriented protocols. The difference is framing of the data. Okay, here the characters are used, here individual bits are used. Thank you.